Good evening, you dear YouTubers. In my last movie, I was saying at the end that maybe I would need a half year for the next movie. But fortunately, I have a small success I want to share with you. What you see on here at the scope, you see. I am pressing here some keys at my PC, and I'm sending serial bytes, the green ones, here, to the Capri board, to my Z180 processor, and it is echoing it back to me. I use on here this this terminal program on there, Capri Z180, is responding, echoing these letters. Yeah. If I would the same thing with a local echo, then every letter I type, Capri is responding, yeah. So it's twice quasi, but I don't know that, right? This is stupid. So local echo off. Oh, let's make this one here. So I can also go to our next line. I want to show you which steps I have done, yeah. So. The first thing is, I will now switch again back to my small wiki, because I'm documenting every step to it. So the first steps of this thing, looking what this thing is doing. And in the last movie, I showed you that the processor is running at 10 megahertz. Though I'm applying a 20 megahertz clock signal to it. This is due to the fact that that at the input of the microprocessor, an additional divider is turned on, and this can be suppressed, this additional division, by setting a specific bit. So my first Hello World program was to turn the microprocessor to maximum speed by setting the specific register and the specific bit to 1. So the CPU control register, and the corresponding hex value is 1F. I try to. And I ORed the address of the register, and I ORed the contents of this register. I'm reading it into the accumulator. I'm ORing it with 80. So I'm setting the most significant bit. This is actually the bit which turns on the functionality that the input divider is turned off. And I'm outputting it back on there. Then I measured a little bit. I hope you can see this a little bit here. This is a picture here. Here in the first line, you see my reset. Yeah? I was pressing and holding my reset, and as I released my reset button, it's on there. And then the program runs, and you can see here firmly that these waves here are a little bit broader than this one here. And at a specific point, they are getting again more narrow, like the yellow one on there. The upper signal here is the 20 megahertz external clock frequency. On here you see 10 megahertz at the phi, which is the internal frequency used by the microprocessor. And suddenly, after a specific time, it's about 5.6 microseconds, I think I have wrote somewhere, I don't know. It is at this position of the program to turn this functionality off. On here you see it more clearly. I zoomed in. You see here the 20 megahertz and here the 10 megahertz. And at a specific point, the internal megahertz is also at 20 megahertz, right? So this was my hello world, actually. So I was sure, okay, my microprocessor is reading instructions properly, and I'm able to program the internal registers with the internal I/O read and write commands in 0 and out 0. This I will explain in a later movie about this. These are additional in or out commands which are built in the microprocessor, caused by the additional functionality of use a memory management unit to address higher memory locations, and they had to change a little bit. I will come next time to that point. So, but the basic thing on here I want to show you, the signal at pin phi was my only indicator which showed me I'm reaching a specific register. And as I realized I'm reaching registers and I'm able to change register values, I could proceed to further steps. Yeah. And the further step was to get the hello to get the serial interface running. For this I studied in the data sheet the specific registers I had to control. So there's a status register, there's a control A register, a control B register, to set the speed and the word sizing, the frame sizing, and also to enable the baud rate generator and this stuff. So as I was sure that I am able to meet to vary specific values into the registers, I could do that actually. So on here I'm configuring it, and the first step was just to output one single byte. I'm outputting here the value 5. It's not understandable for us because value 5 is very below of the ASCII table. But I didn't care about, because I wanted to verify the electrical representation of the serial signal. And I have seen the input of my level shifter. This is the input of my level shifter and the output of my microprocessor of the TX line, that the logic high level is actually 5 volts, as it should be. But the logic low, ground potential is not met. There is an offset about 2 volts. So I was thinking about, oh, what is happening there? So I lifted up the input pin of the level shifter of this line, and I could see that my TTL signal, the output of the microprocessor, is properly formed. It goes from 0 volt to 5 volt and back again. So I was realizing that something with my level shifter is not right. And when I firstly powered up my board, I realized that this thing got hot. So I had to lift up two legs, two input pins actually. I grounded, but this was not good for this IC. So I was thinking this thing is here broken. So I exchanged it. I unsoldered it. I emptied this one here. And I put an additional, a new one on here. But I made on the board, I cut the connections of these two pins to ground, so they have been open. So they are open now. And one pin I forgot to connect to ground. Yeah. So I did this also. And then I connected it back on, and I saw when my program runs and tries to send this value 5, that level shifter is transforming to serial levels. So this logic high on there goes to minus 10 volts, and the logic 0 goes to plus 10 volts. Then I connected, let's move to my board. Then I connected a FTDI thing at the connections on here, and below of it you see the maxim. Oops. On here is the maxim, the level shifter here. And I connected this thing with this cable to my USB thing, which is connected to the PC over there actually. And I and I try to write a small software which outputs the letter K. There's a letter K on here, a very small letter K, yeah, on here. And I could see in the terminal program that is outputting permanently the letter K, 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 at a baud rate of 57 kilobit. Baud rate, kilobit, I don't know, kilobaud, right? But a bit speed is 57 kilobit per second. So I was sure that something is happening here in a positive way. And now my wiki stops because I have not documented it yet, but you have seen it in the beginning of that. I could now type a word and Capri sends back, right? Sends back. This is interesting why I have on there is no local echo, right? And if I enter the enter key once, I have two. This is weird. I'm not sure if or is this like this? Ah, no. Yeah. At the receive line, I'm also yeah. Something like this should be on here. Zack, genau, now it's correct. Genau. Because I sent a catch return and a line feed. And the response of the microprocessor was also a carriage return and a line feed. So I had on here always two enters. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That I wanted to show to you. Now I will move on to understand more in detail my memory management unit. For this program, I did not use the memory. Actually, I stored the received values. Just as simply in the B register. So whenever I read something out of the receive data register, I don't know if you can see that. On here, I'm storing it to value B, to the register B, and at the top somewhere, I'm moving it back from B to A, right? And the other thing is just to poll the receive bit and the send bit. As long as they are active, it is waiting, and if they signal they are empty or they are full for the receive bit. If they are empty, the transmit bit, then I'm writing to the transmit register. And as soon the receive bit says I'm full, I'm taking the values. I'm taking the values of the register, right? So I did not need to access memory actually. No? But this will be now the next few steps I wanna do, and maybe I will manage even to program a small monitor program to to have a look inside of the memory. Yeah, so yeah, I wanted to share with that to you, and yeah, so if you like this, give me a thumbs up and I would be happy about. See you.